Greetings, I, the War Owl, greets you, and welcome to game number two. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the second map of the Virtus.Pro vs. GODSENT series. I got such a positive reception from you guys for the first one that I'm going to be doing the entire series here for your viewing pleasure. Now, this is cash. I think it's definitely going to be favoring Virtus.Pro. Ooh, looks like they want to boost two players up here at the start of this really early. And we see Pasha holding this angle, gonna peek it a little bit, does get the pick off of that player. Pronax moves in and picks off Pasha. That's a trade really early on in that. And he falls back and grabs that bomb. Haven't really decided where they're going just yet. Love them parkour moves. All right, teaming up on Taz. And eventually is able to tap him down. And it looks like they're gonna be taking B right now. So they kept the bomb over at B side for quite a bit of time. Tricked them into doing a rotate out of there. And now it's going to be a difficult retake for these players. We see Snacks and Neo teaming up here to take out JW. And they will. Here comes Crims from the other side. Nice little quick trade. 2v2 now for the retake. Bialy already going for the pick on that player. Here is Schneider. Puts into a 1v1 with Snacks. He's at tree. This means that Snacks can get onto position of the bomb. It's going to force Schneider to push him because of where this bomb is planted. There's the fake. Schneider has to peek it. And Snacks is going to get the pick. What a round. That was an incredibly complex, really interesting round right off the bat here in this game. Well, possibly for a strat talk even. There was a lot happening there. Snacks ends it with a 3-frag, and that is 1 point up for Virtus.Pro on a map. It looked like GODSENT had it. They definitely outplayed Virtus.Pro in terms of the strategy. They tricked them. They got into the site. They got the bomb planted, but Virtus.Pro's shooting just going to be a little bit better. GODSENT had to use those Glocks, and as we all know, Glocks are pathetic. What is this second round buy from GODSENT? We have armor AK-47s on Crims and Flusha. The rest of them are going to have pistols, armor, not on Schneider or Pronax. This is a crazy strategy right now. This is a counter to these players buying up SMGs. Because they got that bomb plant, instead of going for a third round full buy, they're going to try to punish the SMG buy here on round number two. I'm surprised this kind of a strategy isn't making it more into the meta, considering it has the potential of really upsetting, especially considering how SMGs are used so heavily these days. Crims just taking a good position here to deal with close range players. Taz picks up that M4! And gets the spray down. Difficult to do a spray down with this weapon because it only has 20 rounds in it compared to the 30, the M4A4. Oh, good flash. Just waiting for these players. Nothing really happening just yet. Pasha really close to this angle. He's not going to push it because he wants to engage at close range right around that corner. We still have two SMGs up for the CT players. Not going to be super useful. Except against, actually looks like Pronax picking up that AK, so Pronax has no armor. If they're able to get close to him, they can make something happen. Taz heard Flusha's little hoppity hops as he was running down there, so he was able to easily just sit there and wait for him to push. And waiting for Pronax to jump up so he can go for that headshot, and Pronax gets the angle first. So good timing from Pronax in that engagement. Now puts it into a 3v3. Good Molotov to hold this off for just as long as they can. Pasha Biceps gonna let them come into the site. He shouldn't peek here with this weapon. And, well, JW is very low, so he could get the drop on them. Flash will be avoided easily. Does fake down JW and sprays down Pronax with the MP9 going full fur there at bomb site B. Time is up. Snyder will live. 19 health left on this player. If you die after that timer goes off, you get no money. In fact, you get zero reward money for the next round, and all he would have is Deagle, which is not good. Oh, actually, he gets that zero reward money anyway, but it does save the Deagle. So you notice Schneider starting this round with $250. That's not good. You almost think that maybe it would have made more sense for him to just go die. All right. GODSENT is now behind. The gamble did not work. Let's see if they're able to get a fourth round buy off of this. What they threw away, though, was a guaranteed full buy third round. Virtus.Pro probably would have prepared for that, though. They tried to kind of catch them off guard and say, oh, they're going to try to play this SMG play. They're going to be playing anti-eco, and we can do something about it. Crims, in the meantime, pistols down two players, grabs the AK-47, will get taken down. One of these guys needs to grab it, and it gets shot to Flusha. All right, Schneider, 1v3 now with a Deagle. Oh yeah, he inadvertently shot the weapon to his foe. That would have been great if he actually got a frag with that thing off of Bialy. Probably a very embarrassing moment for that player. I mean, that's something you could just make a YouTube video on, right? You'd be like, look at this, player shoots gun to his opponent who then kills him with it. Ha! What a loser. But that did not happen. In fact, maybe you could say it was some next level play of baiting him out with the gun, saying, here you go, sonny, take this AK. That's not what it was, though. It was just dumb luck. Okay. Interesting smoke from Schneider there at middle, counter smoke from the CTs. Just delaying it, so they can't push into middle at the start of it. Is this a boost? This is not a boost, just two players sitting inside of A main. Flashing their way in here. They have a lot of flashes. Well, they only have four flashes left, and they use one just to enter into A main. We got sprays coming down from Crims, looking like they want to do an A take. I mean, oh, that's a good pick, though. Flusha picks up Pasha, who once again peaked this angle. He peaked the same angle he picked before. Here's Neo trying to punish Flusha. Not going to happen. They both peaked that angle. That was really sloppy of them. Two picks at B. Probably a good idea to push at B. It's actually going to force Virtus.pro to sort of spread themselves out a little bit thin here. Nope, they're staying A. So I think Godsend's going to run right into this. Yep, that smoke says we are definitely coming A. There's a flash. Snax is aware. Oh, that's actually another smoke. Ready for these players to push. He heard the footsteps from Crims. Good pick by Bialy at middle, taking out Flusha, who's supposed to get the other position. Snax, what is he going to do with this op? Oh, no, just the perfectly wrong time to pull out that flashbang. And Godsend will take their first point. And that round definitely all came down to this angle right here. We had the CT player, Pasha, peeking it and getting taken down by Flusha, who was holding it like right here. They lost two players to that, and that's kind of what shifted the balance greatly in favor of Godsent in that one. All right, kind of a weird buy coming out here from Virtus.pro. There's another one where you have just two guns for the whole team, and the rest of them just kind of scrounge together whatever they can get. I like this. This is a counter boost spot. So if they boost up, Taz should be able to pop the head. The smoke in middle will clear. No, they're going to re-smoke it, so Taz can hold this position for that much longer. We don't see a boost happening, though. We see the T's kind of pushing forward at B. I think they've kind of decided that, oh, what just happened? Snax, did he do that? Oh, what? Hold on. Is the door open? Yeah, it is. Okay, I was wondering if he just got a random shot through the door, but no, that player did open the door. I think T's are thinking, okay, weak point seems to be this B door area, so Flush is kind of playing it close here, trying to get the pick. But we see Neo and Pasha playing it really passive this time. Look at this positioning. So Pasha's just listening right now and just chilling. If Neo goes down, Pasha picks up the gun, and we have another player inside of the site that they don't even know about. So I like that, teaming up with the gun. Have like a knight and his squire. All right, Bialy. Bialy is the kind of guy who gets one taps here. Let's see if it happens. Well, it's a four tap. That's okay, I guess. Eventually gets taken down. Terrace will be entering into the site. And they definitely will get it. Little fight through the smoke there. Oh, they're actually going to re-smoke the site there. I like that. I like that second smoke that Flusha just threw that blocks off the site and forces them to have to come the forklift way. And good shooting from Flusha. Spray control to take down Pasha. Eventually will go down, and that's going to be a defuse. Virtus.pro will take it. All right, they just kind of stole that round away from Godsent there. And that'll put Virtus.pro well ahead. Economically, I don't know what Godsent is going to be able to do this time. They should be able to get a buy, but yeah, they'll get a buy, but one player will have to pistol, and that's going to be Crims with the Deagle. All right, next round here for Godsent. It's going to be a tough one. JW with the off. JW sitting at just one frag thus far. Really unfortunate. Gonna go for the pick here. Pronax is gonna jump by, try to bait out the shot. JW goes for the kill on Pasha, and Pasha will avoid it. Seems like they are trying to punish Pasha here at B. If they can get that pick, it opens it up for them. All right, Taz is gonna be playing this close as Neo rotates back to play upper. There's a pick from Bialy on Schneider. I think he was, inside of A main. Another pick. JW finally gets a pick there at bombsite B. T's not deciding to push just yet. We do have Taz here close at middle still. Godsent trying to allow Virtus.Pro to spread themselves out across the map. We see them stack up two players A, one holding B, and then one at middle. They don't really have intel about where the CTs are at all, though. I mean, they heard those flashes go down. So they might know that a player is boosted inside of A main. JW gets another pick. There's Crims taking out Taz at middle. Was forced to fall back from that. It's all up to Bialy here. Pretty much the whole round. Well, that's going to be it for him. Pasha has to try and save this AWP now. He's not going to 1v4 with the AWP. We know the T's are going to start hunting him down. As soon as he scopes, that noise will alert the terrorist to his position. So you notice Pasha is intentionally not scoping. He's in a very dangerous position right now, and he's going to have to, sorry to borrow a Call of Duty term, I'm going to feel dirty saying this, but he's going to have to scope quickly. There. I said it differently. How about that? He's going to have to scope quickly here if somebody decides to push him. He heard the footstep, so he knows JW is close. Oh, he heard the weapon switch. Let's see if he can get the kill. He'll have to scope and then shoot immediately. Oh, they're going to walk by. So Pasha will survive. Ooh, that. Oh, he used the flashbang to scope. It's the little things. And then Pasha gets the pick. Pasha must have picked up that skill when he transitioned to a lurk player. Scoping in when the flashbang goes off so the guy can't hear it. Now he's going to be using a Mag 7 this round, throwing the AWP over to Snacks. And we have a kind of a tough round here. This is a round where Virtus.Pro should have bought fully. I think they can make something happen here with the weapons that they did buy. But even if they spent all their money, they'll be able to buy two rounds from now. Assuming they lose the rounds. Well, there goes the AWP. So this round's definitely not going to happen. Terrorists getting ready to push into the site. That smoke will delay them long enough that CTs will have a chance to rotate into position. They already have control of Forklift. They know Taz is up there. Terrorists can still take this site. They already have good position. Bialy gonna clip through the door a little bit. Crims showing why he was once, for a brief moment in history, the best player in the world. And it is Pasha. Pasha will kill Schneider and grab this AK-47, so that's 900 in the bank for that kill, and he grabs the AK. Hopefully he can save this thing for the next round for the Virtus.Pro. He's gonna have to solo it, though. He'll probably throw that AK to somebody else. Well, if he saves it. Liberal use of flash will not affect Pasha, though. They may be able to outsmart Pasha, but they can't outsmart AK-47. He's gonna hide inside a B right now. Is the terrorist strike force hunting him down, checking their corners? And they will not find him. So Pasha saves the AK for the next round. Virtus.Pro goes into a save round, and Godsent has taken the economic momentum. So we should see some pistol buys from Virtus.Pro, and that's it. All right. Tough round for Virtus.Pro. What do you do? Do you stack a bomb site? Do you try and do some kind of a push at middle? What do you do? You could do a four stack with one player on one site, or you could just play it completely standard and try to get the picks. Gotta play close angles, though, as well. So they kept, because he has armor, he has kit, he has nades, and the AK-47. Pasha will hang on to that at B. They know that Pasha is the B player. That may be reasoning behind their decision to take bomb site A. They've already smoked off Snacks' position. And leaving Neo solo, and they're going to rotate Pasha. So the smoke will delay long enough and allow Pasha to get into position. But they are going to commit. They're definitely going to commit to this bomb site take. Molotov preventing Crims from coming out. Kind of odd that they would throw that. Maybe they just want to pick him off. Smoke goes down. Interesting position for that smoke. Normally you're going to block off between spools and the shipping container. Pronax gets the pick on the entry. Looks like they are going to get into the site. Pasha dead. All they really want to try to do here is get some picks. It's just Neo left. Taz was able to take down Flusha, but that's it. That's not good for a round where you have an AK-47, an armor player, on the field. It's not good for a standard save round. A sort of standard save round will go to the effect of taking two players out. If you can steal a gun and save it, it's gone really well. Well, they're gonna get nothing. This puts GODSENT very far ahead right now. Virtus.Pro might think about switching up how they're doing this. Pasha gonna get the AWP instead of snacks. I think he's gonna be playing B with it. He'll probably go for the pick. We have no AWP on GODSENT, though. Oh, there it is on JW. Never mind. He just had his pistol out. And he's gonna go for the pick. We'll see who gets it, Flusha or Pasha. Nope. Flash will come down. Very good throws from Flusha. You see how he's playing this? He knows exactly what Pasha's going to do before Pasha knows he's gonna do it. And he knows his player's gonna be there too. Oh, and they both hit each other, wow. Next level Counter-Strike, ladies and gentlemen. Legendary players going at it here. All right, Grimm's in a dangerous spot. This is a spot where if you have an AWP player here in A, that's kind of where they're gonna be wall banging. But I guess they know that the AWP, oh, okay, Pasha gonna be playing mid. Did Schneider get by? Wow, we have two players at mid right now that Pasha is unaware of. See, JW and Schneider get a little crossfire here. They could easily punish Pasha with this. They have utility. Schneider has a Molotov he could throw. Without even being seen, he could throw this Molotov down. Oh, they're just going to push through to B. This is going to cause Pasha to rotate. JW going to be going for the rotate players. Bialy turns around, comes back to A. So they're like, oh, they didn't push completely. GODSENT playing the map right now. They've taken control of mid. Very good positioning. They are outplaying them right now. Krims gets the pick into the site. Krims tries to solo his way in there, and he does trade. Schneider moves into B to try to get a pick. Ain't gonna happen! Almost had a little Goomba stomp as Taz jumps on top of JW. Surprise. Wow, goodness. Terra's gonna be entering into the site. Just gonna be snacks. And... oh, he'll be able to mow that down. Yeah, and snacks gets both the kills. Virtus.Pro now 5-4. GODSENT has to win this map or they are done. They are officially not in the tournament. This is actually the wild card qualifier, which basically means tournament organizers want to get these high profile teams into their tournament because it brings in the moolah. So Virtus.Pro and GODSENT, two teams with huge fan bases. Well, I guess GODSENT doesn't really have the fan base. It will. It will. Ex-Fanatic fans should quickly switch to GODSENT. All right, 2 versus 4, or 5. Oh man, well, you know what? Honestly, good on Neo for getting that pick on Pronax when he got Molotov'd out of his position. Good for him. That was a tough round. GODSENT took that so quickly. They're showing to be very, very good at these quick A takes. Even if they play it slow, it seems like they are outplaying Virtus.Pro. However, the score is 5-5 right now. But yeah, doesn't it seem like GODSENT is outsmarting Virtus.Pro most of the time here? They seem to be playing them like a fiddle. Why can't GODSENT get the points? Oh, Taz. That was foolhardy, my friend. Two players at white box. Flusha has to contend with both of them. Look at that spray transfer on Bialy. Holy crap. All right, well, that's pretty much the round. Flusha is a beast. I don't know how he does it. All right, we'll see if he can hunt down this player at truck right now. Neo's gonna peek him. Bop! Goes the weasel. And not that Neo is a weasel, it's just a saying. Pasha, 1 versus 5. With a P250. His mission, kill somebody and take their gun. Will he accept it? Or is he going for exits? I don't know. All right, here comes JW. And we have Pronax there. He can't take them together. I would love for Flusha to find him, though, so we could get his ace. But Flusha's on the exact other side of the map, so not gonna happen. Oh, dear. Still a four frag from Flusha. It was anti-ego, but an ace is an ace, and a four frag is a four frag. And it pads your stats. All right. Godsent now back into the lead. Virtus.Pro had a little chance to upset it there. But now they've fallen behind in the economy, and we have a mag 7 on Pasha. Terrorist going a little bit A-sided here. May set up for a push, throw their smokes and flashes, and if they can't make it happen, they'll fall back from it. Snacks goes for the pick! I don't know how he got that. Crims, oh, because Taz also peeked with him. May have thrown off Crims a little bit. You are at 6 health, buddy. Better get out of there. And he, like a gentleman, he closes the door on his way out. JW is snuck by the door here. Get a better vantage point for this AWP pickety picks. Will he get the pick? If they get the pick, they're gonna push, but CTs have rotated 4 players there. Pronax gets the pitch, JW gets the pick, and he sees Taz at the last second, but Schneider's able to trade with him. Neo rotating, Snacks on the site. He could do some damage with this mag 7. 6 health left, but all he's gotta do is tap him once in the chest at this range. 2 players getting ready to push it. Neo has rotated into position and is fighting the player at forklift right now. That's Schneider. I really want to see this mag 7 play, though. Oh, no! Snacks! What an opportunity. Wasted. That was a... Snacks is falling apart. The guy who... Another player who at one point was the best player in the world for a brief moment has just... That was not good, Snacks. All right. If he just touched the fire there, he would be dead. Neo is making things happen. And 1v2 now. Tough position. His flashes have been on point. Neo's, his 2 flashes, both of them have completely flashed all of the opponents. Oh my gosh. Flusha down to 48 health. He goes for the kill. Flusha shoots off of a ladder. Flusha, no. I just made a whole video, and the whole point of the video is don't shoot off of a ladder, but he did it successfully. So who am I to complain? Alright, well, that's gonna force Virtus.Pro into another save. What a round. That was an opportunity for Virtus.Pro to take it there. I think if Snacks was able to get that USP kill on the completely flashed, completely just standing there player, it would have gone differently. Oh, good. A little bit of damage on Taz there. Sorry, it's not Schneider anymore, is it? It's Znagder. Well. Players are dying. Terrorists have taken B site. JW still going for the rotates. This seems to be Godsent's little strategy when they take it. They use 4 players, this time 3, to take the site. A little bit safer. They got to put a player to watch JW's back, considering it's anti-eco. And then JW kind of sits there and watches to kill the rotators. So the only place the rotators can come from is from CT spawn. Look at this. Bialy snuck his way in here, you sneaky, beaky little corpse. 1v4. Snacks. Time to redeem himself. Get a pick. Can he? No, no, no. All right, here we go. 2 rounds left. Virtus.Pro gonna buy it. They have to win this. Godsent is taking quite the advantage on their own map. Again, I would assume Virtus.Pro would play cash much better with this lineup versus this lineup. However, the strength of Virtus.Pro definitely comes into terrorist side and their bomb site takes. Same skills factor into a retake, but you could say that Virtus.Pro still has a shot once they get onto the T side. There is no team, I think, that matches them on their bomb site takes on cash. Maybe some of the North American teams. Let's just say they're the best European team at it. All right, terrorists will be taking bomb site B. Pasha solo in the site. Neo from tree. Good vantage point. Does some serious damage. Pasha gets the pick as well. They're getting ready to push it. Schneider goes for the pick. Everybody is flashed. Everybody is flashed. Well, except for Snacks. Here he comes. And that's going to be the rest of the deaths. Pasha with a 3 frag holding off that bomb site. We move into the final round. And Godsent definitely has the money to buy. Virtus.Pro was able to take that point. They are still in this game. And no matter how this goes, both teams are pretty even here, moving into the second half. Here we go. Final round. Because they have so much money, they're going to be a double op on T side, which is, let's say, unheard of for cash. I guess some teams can pull it off. Crims with the op. Sorry, I said his name very strange there, and I apologize for confusing you. I almost sounded like a real caster there for a second, right? Krim's gonna be pushing into the site here, takes the pick, going for the wall bang, and holding this angle right now. Oh, we get a pick from Flusha on the other side of the map, taking down Pasha with one hit to the head, taking out 100 of his hit points. All right, I'll stop. I could do that all day. Krim's just missing Bialy there. 2 versus 5. Virtus.Pro looking like they're gonna end the half 6-9. There's the smoked ender into the site. Bialy, time to make some magic happen. Good Molotov to delay the push just a little bit more, but they have a minute left. JW moves in from the other side. And Snacks, gotta get an ace. Definitely, definitely not going to happen. And there, ladies and gentlemen, is your halftime. I will freeze frame on the halftime score since they made it go bye-bye so, oh so very quickly, and we shall resume when the teams are ready to commence this match. I like Cash. I used to really dislike Cash. It's a map that kind of came around after I stopped playing Counter-Strike. So I only really have played it inside of Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Never really took to it, but just, you know, kind of recently in the past year or so, I've been really enjoying it, and it's kind of the map I would prefer to play, especially over maps like Overpass or Cobblestone, which I have no love for. All right, same strategy, except without the B presence here for the terrorist team. Pasha and Taz just kind of chilling, reminiscing. Hey, remember when we were good? Oh, man, I can't say things like that. Oh, no. All right, they're going to be doing an A take with a split there at middle. That's not good that the bomb went down. They're going to wait for these players at highway to come. Oh, this is not. This is just not. Wow, Flusha. Flusha, are you kidding, my boy? I don't know what to say about that one, Flusha. All right, so there's the first round. GODSENT will be taking it pretty easily there. Remember how I raved about Virtus.Pro's T side? That exploded in their faces. Looks like we're gonna see a game number 3. Well, I already know what's gonna happen. I'm not gonna spoil it. This game's already been played. I'm not doing this live. I'm no Bill O'Reilly. Well, there's the pick from Bialy. Just Krim's left on the site. They had, like, a small window of opportunity where they could have taken advantage of that, but that is over because here comes Flusha. So instead of moving in a little bit late, they're going to rotate and try to take A, try to outplay. Pronax is sitting here with his UMP. Whoa, the pick's at middle. JW picks off Neo. Snacks will open this door, definitely. The jumping Tech 9 popped to the face. This is a random gun, so lucky, lucky Snacks there. CT's moving in to try to do a retake. That is a very good nade. We'll take Taz down to half health right now. I gotta remember that nade. And the UMP spray down. Flusha is intent on retaking this site. Where the heck is Snacks? And, oh, there he is. And here comes Pasha from the other side. Snacks should wait until the backstab. There it is. And that's going to be another win. Oh no, the tables have shifted. Virtus.Pro just won the pistol round on that. Just stole that away from GODSENT. GODSENT should do an armor pistol buy on this round. They should full buy. They're not. Okay, so they're going to be doing the pistol 2 round. Well, I guess Flusha got some armor. Basically, what they want to do is buy on round number 5. So round 3 and 4... they're kind of screwed. They can use the money they get for that round in order to buy for number 5. So, T's already getting the picks. Already taking the site. Love that position from Flusha. But it's a man against an army with an e-witty-witty-biddle gun. It's just not going to happen. Neil's like, but I thought he was here, guys. Where could he have gone? What magic is this? Neo! Really, buddy? And Flusha will now get hunted down. Oh, he was definitely on that player through that wall. I wish he clicked. I wish he clicked. If he clicked, you guys would be making GIFs. Yeah, I say GIF. Choose the internet users, choose GIF. I'm aware that the proper English way to say the word is GIF. However, the creator of it has said it should be pronounced GIF, and you know what? I'm gonna respect his wishes. You don't take someone's name and pronounce it how it's pronounced in your own language, right? Like English. Like if I take a German name and try to say it in how an English person would say it, it doesn't sound right, right? How about Ludwig von Beethoven? It sounds terrible. Well, Virtus.Pro able to take the bomb site. Two players left. We got the whole team shooting at him. I'm trying to figure out which one is going to get the kill. It actually was Bialy. Let's play a little game of who's going to get the kill. And Bialy it was, taking down three players. All right, well, the score is evened up thanks to Virtus.Pro's economic lead. We now move into the gun round. So here we go. First gun round of the half, and we'll see how these teams kind of spread up and do this thing. Neo, you might want to upgrade. Seriously. You know what, Neo? I'm not going to tell you how to play your game. You play your game. You get a kill, though. Prove me wrong, Neo. Get a kill with that MAC-10. Where are they going to be playing this? All right, lots and lots of stuff coming across over here at middle. Going to force Schneider into the little corner there. And they know what's up. There comes the Molotov to force Schneider out. Taz gets the kill. See some suppressive fire from Snacks, just in case that player peeked over the top of it. There they go. A little bit late on that. Actually allowed JW to almost get a pick on them. We saw the timing on JW. Actually, because they were late, JW's pick missed, because JW was completely flashed. He just threw a round down there when he thought they were going to peek. So waiting a few seconds just saved their life. So all this commotion at middle allows Neo to sneaky-beaky his way into a checkers. Krim should see this, though. If he, what? Wow, Neo just picked Flusha somehow. The timing on... Neo is insane. The timing on that spray to hit the player as they jumped out of the vents was really insane. All right, JW, gonna try to survive here. Close that door so when they come sniffing around, when Detective Neo comes around the corner... Oh, wait, they're gonna find him anyway. Oh, wow, third-person perspective there, guys. Remember when they tried to put Counter-Strike on television and it was always in third-person? Who remembers that? Like, the only way to spectate it was third-person. It was absolutely terrible. Like, could you imagine having to watch this game like this? Like, alright, here comes the counter-terrorist now leaving the site. And here's Snacks with the AWP. He's gonna pick middle. They probably didn't even know what to name it. With the sniper. Going for the sniper kill. Gets the sniper kill! Wow, 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 wow. Lots of damage being done, but no deaths. I guess they're softening them up for Krims, and, well, Krims goes for the one digs, so maybe not. Oh, just almost hit Neo there, but Neo was able to take him down. Virtus.Pro just took the lead. 11-10 right now. Next gun round. Virtus.Pro is on fire. They are dominating Godsend. Godsend hasn't made anything happen since the pistol round in this. Look at the money on Virtus.Pro. So dominant here on T side. So exactly what we thought was going to happen happened. Virtus.Pro dominates the T side on this. What is Godsend doing wrong? Snacks is already holding this angle. Don't peek it, Flusha. Don't peek it, buddy. Pasha, how? I guess he stood in his own Molotov or something, or I don't even know. That is a late game smoke middle, 1 minute 20 seconds. They have one smoke left on Krims, and Virtus.Pro will have 50 seconds to do whatever they want with the map. And waiting, Neo. There it is. Beautiful. Absolutely stunning. All right, it's going to be an A take. Neo is actually already rotated to help with this. Tough hold off. Let's see if JW can get the pick. And that is a yes. Now they know where he is, though. B Bialy getting ready to enter. He'll definitely try to peek JW here, but Pronax sprays him down, watching his buddy's back. JW, in the meantime, is able to pick up another frag because of that, and we just have Neo left, 3 health left, running away and trying to survive. Krims moving in from the other angle to take him down, and should go for that body shot, should have good communication to let Krims know that Neo is low. 11-11 all tied up. Godsent is able to take it back. They did a great job on that round in particular, and how they held off bomb site A. Very good setup. Seems like Virtus.Pro should have been able to Molotov JW out. They don't know where he's going to play from, though, but after the first frag, after the first pick, should have readjusted. But they didn't have players at A main to do that. Notice how on T side, Virtus.Pro hasn't been playing too many people inside of A main. It's been like one player. The rest go around on the other sides. It's kind of unique, especially at amateur level of play. Most teams are going to put like the majority of their players into A main when doing an A take. This time it's just Bialy. Right, they're going for picks right now. Flusha has yet to peak this position, which is good for him. Very passive CT side from Godsent. They've kind of abandoned A right now. Gone very heavy B side. I wonder what the intel they got that kind of told them that this was going on. Well, Pronax is coming back. So he can watch door, and then he can watch A main. 50-second smoke going down there. And it will be a B take. Krims and Schneider to hold this off. Waiting for those smokes to clear. Let's get a good angle here. And there's the smoke to block off CT. Player could push through it or go upper. Said he's just going to stay there and spray through it. All right, they have almost taken the site. One player to take down. Trade their way in, puts it into 2v2. Death from above. JW with the P250. And there is what was supposed to be the trade. Flusha hops in at the last second and saves JW. 2-op CT side now from Godsent. A good job taking back that momentum, taking back the round. And look at this. Virtus.Pro and that big bank that they've been able to accrue allows them to get another full buy. This is their third round after losing those two where they've been able to full buy like this. Pretty much Virtus.Pro has not saved this entire half. Ooh. Snacks. So what he's doing here is if the player shoulder peeks, he's going to be able to get him through the corner. Oh, almost hit him, actually. Or if he sees the gun peek out. Huh, that worried me a little bit. I thought, just because of how we see the x-ray, I thought the player actually was just gonna run out there like that. He would definitely go down as a result of that. All right, Snacks running around in the middle. This is a very exposed position. A player white box should be able to kill him if he's there, but nobody's playing white box. Smoke mid will clear in a few seconds, so they have to be mindful of that. Flusha should peek it as soon as that's clearing. Well, he sprays through. Could have actually probably gotten the kill if he just waited a little bit there. All right, Terrace take control of mid. I'm going to boost Snacks up, see if he can get this pick on JW. JW now holding at middle. Not allowing them to be seen. Let's get on JW for this. And oh, Pasha takes him out that time. Last time it was JW killing Pasha. There's the pick. We'll see if that switches the fortunes. Nice kill from Pasha. Was that a no-scope? Certainly looked like it. Sometimes on the demos, you can't tell. I think it was a scope, though. He probably scoped to get that. And Krim should be able to kill Pasha as he's exiting. Very foolish, Pasha. Running around with his knife out. Allows Krims to seal this up. Celebrating a little bit too soon, buddy. And oh, wow. Neo hops up and gets taken down. Krims with the AWP doing economic damage. But Bialy's finally able to take him down. 12-12, all tied up again. Really close game. Surprisingly close. All right, this is forces Godsend into a save. Virtus.Pro has quite the advantage. I'd say I'd definitely give the advantage right now to Virtus.Pro. And they're doing this 2-AWP on T side. So we got both Pasha and Snacks with the AWP. Look at this little swarm of CTs. See where they finally decide to end up. They have no intel right now. Virtus.Pro still playing it pretty slow. Now they put two players over here in A. They're like moving all together as like one glob right now. So they've decided A is the happening place to be right now, where all the cool kids are. However, Virtus.Pro is taking it slow. They're trying to figure out where these CTs are in case they try to do exactly what they're doing. And Bialy, the forward scout, is like, hey guys, it's clear. They decide to take bomb site B. Nope, not gonna happen, and this should be a win here for Virtus.Pro. I don't know how you can retake this with pistol players with no utility. No nades. All right. Oh, what? Okay, no, that was Taz who got that. Don't get too excited, guys. He didn't just pull what Simple tried to pull two majors ago. All right, Flusha. Gonna try to get an exit kill. Oh, he could get that and takes out Bialy. A little bit of economic damage. Like a hornet stinging and falling back. He's going to go for another one here. Ah, not going to happen. They had two players holding that. Snacks with a three frag. I just thought he got the jumping no-scope for a brief moment. I was filled with glee. With pure glee. All right, 13-12. Virtus.Pro takes quite the advantage. We move into a gun round, and this is pretty much it. Godsend's got to win this one. All right, they're going heavy, heavy A side right now. Here's JW. He's got to get this pick. He's got to get this pick. And he does. Bodes well for Godsend. Flash himself out for the peek, and probably should just hold this angle. Terrorists starting to fall off of it a little bit. Nope, looks like they want to peek it still. JW still going to hold the angle. There's the smoke. Going to allow them to get into the site. Oh, look at this positioning. Taz takes out Pronax, just JW. They know they got a lone AWP player here that they can abuse. Oh, how does he hit that? Hits a flying Taz down to 7 health. And smoke's clearing. Good flashes, Molotov forcing him out. JW going to burn to death. Burn the witch, it's just Schneider, 1v3. Players are so low though that he actually might make more sense to pistol. Except for Pasha, who's at full health. And Schneider will save, Virtus.Pro takes it. Wow, that's gonna give him 14 points. This is tough, looks like Godsend is going to be playing for the tie. I say that because next round, what are they going to force by? We'll see. This is kind of an interesting moment for a team to decide. What do we do? I don't think there's a right answer. Do we go for the win or do we go for the tie to push it into overtime? And they are on their last leg, though. I don't know. They might. They have a lot to lose, so they will probably play it safe. I'm going to say they're going to play it safe and not buy. We'll see how right I was. Notice I didn't say we'll see if I'm right. Oh, no. I was wrong. Godsend is going to be buying up. They will not try to push it into a save. Here we go. We got ops, scouts, deagles, pharmacists, UMPs. Every color of the rainbow here from Godsend. They are not playing it safe. And Virtus.Pro again setting up on the A side. Oh, I love this position from Pronax. Re-smoke it as well. Kind of dangerous to stand there with the smoke out, though, because what if a guy runs right into your face trying to get the forklift? There's the re-smoke. Neo seemed to kind of know where he was for a second, but he's just peeking these positions right now. This is good because it prevents that player, Neo, from knowing where he is. He now knows because of that nade trajectory. Goes for the pick on Neo. Can he get this? Can he get this? Flashing himself in. That will hit Neo. Nope. Oh, I think that was a no scope. All right, it looks really tough for Godsend right now, guys. Not gonna lie, Snacks, you did see that. And Neo finds the angle on Crims. Just gonna be Schneider left. 1 versus 4. Really, really rough. He's gonna wanna have to save this AWP. Gonna wanna need a... No product placement, guys. We did that. That was last video. Alright, Schneider. You can hide, but you can't run, because if you run, you'll make noise. And then they'll find you. By the way, Schneider, you just made a huge mistake jumping up there. Now you're committed. If you hop down, you make a little tippity-tippity-top-top noise. So you're kind of stuck, Schneider. You're kind of stuck. Yeah, doesn't look like they're gonna find him just yet. I mean, they know it's important to hunt him down. Look at the money. Terra should be actively hunting down Schneider. Oh, did he hear the drop? I heard it on my end, but I don't know if he did. Bialy's footstep. Well, he definitely heard him now. Very odd that he didn't switch, because, I mean, it was obvious Bialy was going into checkers, even without the x-ray. Based on the sound and what he was throwing and stuff. All right, well, Virtus.Pro match point right now, up 1-0 in this best of three series. Looking rough for Godsent. They have another one of these crazy rounds. No ops though. Double op for Virtus.Pro. And they're gonna be rushing down middle. Schneider! Survives that, able to grab the AK-47. Rushing middle did work, but this does open up either bomb site. Terrorists are taking their time, though. They've lost a player. That's pretty rough. I didn't really react to it very much. Well, let's get on Taz here. He's going to try to get picks. Flush at white box. That flash will hit him and allow Taz to peek a little bit more. A little arson spree at mid. Wow, we have 4 counter terrorists set up to defend A. Nice pick from Taz. They know Virtus.Pro wants to take A. They've been taking A over and over and over and over again. Oh, good, good, good. Spray down Taz now at 3 frags. Looking like this is going to be it, guys. JW, we need some thrilling heroics, buddy. 2 versus 4. Just Crims. 19 health left. And it's not going to happen. There it is. And Virtus.Pro will win this series 2-0, knocking out Godsent and earning themselves a position in ESL. Well, that was fun. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you folks very much for watching. Hope you have a lovely evening. I am TheWarOwl, and I still have no closer. One hit to the head, taking out 100 of his hit points.